Hello everyone, welcome back to Explore China, Chanzhou Zhongguo, and today I'm here in the city of Erfurt, which is the capital of the province Thuringia. And this is located in the very center of Germany, and so it is also the center of Europe. And just in this town, or close by this town, in another town called Arnstadt, this is where the company Kettle, the largest producer of lithium-ion battery cells, is going to set up the European production base. And today I will be going there and introduce you to the company Kettle, the contemporary Amperex Technology, which is a stock company, and its Chinese name is Ningde Shi Dai Keji Gufen Yosien Gongsi. So it's like a science and technology limited liability joint stock company. And currently I'm on my way to my host from Couchsurfing, and yeah, he's so kind to host me, and then we will in this afternoon drive to the production site, to the construction site of the new setup of Kettle Europe. And here then will be called CATT, so CATT for Contemporary Amperex Technology Thüringen, Thuringia. So let's go. Now, first of all, I introduce you to you, my host, Georg.
Yeah, I'm George.
Yeah, and we just drove here from his place in Erfurt down here to Arnstadt, 25 minutes. Mm-hmm. And yeah, thank you again that you can host me. And he has all the knowledge about batteries and engineering.
Yeah, a bit. Yeah.
And yeah, here we're just in front of the German CATT, or the German the Kettle, the Contemporary Amperex Technology Thuringia GmbH. GmbH is like the German for Yosien Gongsi, so for a limited liability company. And here it says Degor Shidai Sin Nengyuan Keji Tulingen. So Tulingen is like the phonetic translation for Thuringia, and Keji Science and Technology, Sin Nengyuan, it means like new resources, so new resources department of science and technology. And one very interesting thing is what just two workers from Kettle, they told us, is that here they're going to assemble the modules of these lithium-ion batteries, and over there in this new now construction site where they are soon going to build the cells, and then they will bring them over here. And they told us, I think in 2022 they want to start to assemble these lithium-ion battery cells. The Kettle, this was found, I think, at first of all as ATL only, and then in 2011 they formally found this company with their founder Robin Tseng. His name, Chinese name, was Tseng Yunchun. Yeah, do you think electric vehicles, passenger electric vehicles and battery cells in Germany, they have a future?
Yeah, of course, we have a lot of companies, you know, BMW, Mercedes, Volkswagen, and of course they need a lot of batteries in the future. And yeah, this plant is really useful for these manufacturers.
Okay, yeah, and I think they will employ around 2,000 new employees they want to employ here. Yeah. But in Germany, out of my perspective, I think many people say, oh, electric cars, they won't have a future here because maybe hydrogen cars will come somewhere in the future.
Yeah, I think hydrogen is interesting maybe for really far distances, but for the short distances, maybe around 200 to 400 kilometers per trip, battery electric cars are the future, of course, because hydrogen is not so efficient. You have a lot of losses if you want to produce hydrogen, and yeah, it's more complex to store and to transport. So
okay, so for the next future of maybe 10 to 30 years, electric cars will be the main choice for German buyers,
probably. Yeah, I think so. And yeah, you only need a powerful socket to charge your car, and if you combine it with photovoltaic, it's perfect.
Okay, okay. Yeah, then let's hope so that Kettel in Germany, this I think one of the first Chinese companies who produce things in Germany or in Europe. That's a really great opportunity and I'm happy to be part of this. And now let's go down there. This year in August at the, where I have it here, on the 12th of August, the chairman and the founder, Robin Zeng, or yeah, Zeng Yunchun, he said that during this year, 2020, in the first 6 months, the market for electric or new resources vehicles in China declined by 44%, while the this market for new energy vehicles in Europe increased by 54%. So the market for cattle in China now currently is declining, even though they have partnerships with NIO or BYD. But still, now Europe is becoming more important for them. And the year-on-year revenue from 2018 to 2019 increased by 53.81% to a total of 14.5 billion renminbis, and the profit also increased by 32.68%. And here, just on the back of the of the construction site, and it is as big as 84 football fields. And George, you just told me a very cool story about this place with the small hills.
Yeah, we see here one of the three hills with the castles. And yeah, there was in the ancient time one horrible night with a lot of rain and storm and with lightnings. And at one time in the three castles at the same time, lightning go in and the castles start to burn and burn down.
Okay. And you said that here in the ancient times there was a famous street going through.
Yeah, there was the Via Regia. It was a trading lane. So from Spain, Santiago de Compostela, the famous city, to Moscow through this area, goods and a lot of stuff were transported by traders, and make this the cities in this area relatively rich. Yeah.
And as we stand here on this side of the construction site, I want to show you this signs here. So I believe that Kettel, they chose this location because of the strong logistic advantage they could have here, is because they are near to two big highways, the A4 and A71, and they are also quite in the center of Germany. So in the north they have the car producer company Volkswagen in Wolfsburg, and in the south in Bavaria and in Baden-Württemberg there they have like Daimler and BMW. So they and in the east they have Czechoslovakia with Skoda. So they have quite a good position here, I think, for battery cells. And what I also wanted to say is lithium production. What I found out is that the most of lithium is produced in Australia, second is in Chile, then China, and in the last position you have Argentina. These are the four biggest lithium mining places. Yeah. Do you want to say, you want to add anything?
I know in Bolivia there are a lot of salt lakes, or one big salt lake, and also German companies produce lithium in this salt lake. And we have in Germany geothermal power plants in the south, And one scientific project is to collect the lithium out the water from the ground. So
in Germany.
In Germany, to produce lithium in Germany, yes.
Okay, do you think the amount of production of lithium which they could get from there is like,
I think I read about 20 tons per year or more. Yeah.
Okay.
We will see.
Okay. Nice. Okay, so it's Sunday morning and I already have to leave. Yep. And I thank you a lot, Georg, for having me here and for sharing all your knowledge. Mm-hmm. It was a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, it was also a pleasure for me, and you are a really good guest for Couchsurfing. And yeah, we talked a lot and shared our knowledge. It was a lot of fun. And here for you, this is a lithium ion battery or a cell of this, and Kettle will produce this in the future, and
not bigger ones,
and stack this together to a big battery for big cars.
Okay.
But this is the smallest piece of a battery, and this I think is the future.
Okay, cool. Yeah, okay, thank you.
Yeah,
thank goodbye
you. Yeah, goodbye,
see you again. See you.